So in this video, I'd like to discuss what a linear inequality really means. So here we have a graph linear inequality, x minus 2y is less than or equal to negative 1. And you can see here that there's a boundary line that is solid, which is good because you have a less than or equal to, and also you have a shaded area which represents all solutions. But I'm going to talk about what that means. This boundary line is x minus 2y equals negative 1. So what about all this shaded part? What does that mean? Well, since we're talking less than or equal to negative 1, let's pick a number less than or equal to negative 1. What if we say x minus 2y equals negative 2? What would that look like? Well, to graph this, take the x part, it would be just x equals negative 2, and take the y part, negative 2y equals negative 2, divide by negative 2, y equals positive 1. Here are intercepts. So the x would be at negative 2, y would be at positive 1, and the pattern would continue like this. Okay, so there's our line. Notice it's parallel to the original boundary line. Now what if we had another one? Let's say x minus 2y equals negative 8. Okay, well, the x-intercept is negative 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's going to be off right here. And then for the y, negative 2y equals negative 8 divided by negative 2. So y equals 4. So the y-intercept would be 4. Should be right here. So I pick points that don't really show up on the grid, but that's okay. So there's a line for that. Be another parallel line. Okay, now each line here represents all the points that could exist for each equals situation. So for one example, you have this one. X minus 2y is negative 1. X minus 2y is negative 2. X minus 2y is negative 8. Basically, you pick any number less than or equal to negative 1, and then you say that's equal to x minus 2y, and then you graph a parallel line. So the shaded area is really just all the parallel lines that could be created by using any number less than or equal to negative 1. So this is really a lot of values, because you think of a line, it contains an infinite number of points. You pick any x value, and then you'll get a y value that goes on this line. And you can say that for any line that goes in the shaded area, it's parallel to the boundary line. And then there's an infinite number of lines that are in the shaded area, because you could pick any value besides negative 1. I mean, you could put negative 1.00000000, and you could go on forever, 1, and that will create a line. There's an infinite number of values that are less than or equal to negative 1. So the shaded area represents all the points that could be on all the lines that are parallel to this boundary line of x minus 2y equals negative 1. So once again, this inequality means you have an infinite number of parallel lines to this x minus 2y equals negative 1, and you pick the values that are less than negative 1 to create those lines. So that's what the shaded area really represents.